Good morning, guys. Today I am explaining about what are the basic components of hydraulic system. Okay, in previous classes we are discussing about the what is the introduction of hydraulic system and pneumatic system, and also we will discuss about the what are the applications and what are the advantages, disadvantages of the fluid power control systems of hydraulic system. So today we are discussing about the what are the basic components involved in the hydraulic system and how it should be work, and what are those components involved in the hydraulic system. Okay, so basic hydraulic system comprises a source of pressurized fluid. It supplies the line of carrying the pressurized fluid. In the hydraulic system is we are flowing the fluid. Okay, it means controlling the power and means of reconverting the fluid power to mechanical power. So it should be converted into a fluid power to the mechanical power. It should be converted into a hydraulic power into a mechanical power. So what is the meaning of hydraulic system? It means what's the flow of control of hydraulic system? It means it should be converted into a fluid power to mechanical power. So that hydraulic power is converted into, is finally converted into a mechanical power. So it is the hydraulic system. So what are the different components involved in the hydraulic system? So you can see a power source unit and power control units and drive units is there. So it should be divided into three categories. The first one is power sources unit. If the power source unit means it is a tank or reservoir, filters, hydraulic piping, positive displacement pumps. So these are the power source units. So the tank or reservoir, so it should be pressurized. It should be pressurized tanks, vented tanks, oil cooler. So these type of tanks are used in the hydraulic system. So filters, suction filter, return line, pressure line filters. So these type of different filters we can use the hydraulic system. Okay, and hydraulic piping system. So we can use different types of piping systems, but in hydraulic piping system, hose, pipe, fittings, pressure gauge, temperature gauge, these type of pipes are only used in the components of the hydraulic system. Okay, so and the next one is the positive displacement pump. In that pumps, there is a different pumps are there. Okay, in pneumatics there is a different pumps are used, and hydraulics there is a different pumps are used. So it should be varied upon our basic operation. So the positive displacement pumps are internal and external gear pumps. So we can use the hydraulic machinery, we can use the internal and external gear pump. Screw and lobe, vane, plunger pump, piston pump. So these type of pumps are used in the hydraulic system. And the next one is power control units to control the power. Okay, so the flow control valve to control the flow of fluid in the pipeline system, to control the flow. Why? Because if the pressure is very high, it should be varied of output, and it should be changes in inputs. So the flow control valve, we can control the flow fluid. So it is regulating type, control type. So these are the two different types of flow control valves. And check valves, so these are the NRV, pilot operated check valves, pressure relief valves, unloading valves. So these are the different pressure control valves. Okay, and the direction control valves to change the direction in the flow of fluid. So at this it is a poppet, spool, rotary valves, 1, 2, 3 counterbalance valves and safety valves. So these are the valves. And the last one is actuators. So it is a linear actuators or rotary actuators or one or two cylinder actuators, telescopic cylinder, hydraulic motors. These are the different actuators using the hydraulic system. Okay, so you can see it is the working of hydraulic system. Okay, it is the working of hydraulic system. So you can see the line diagram of the basic components of hydraulic system. So there is a different components involved in the hydraulic system. So the first one is oil reservoir. Oil reservoir, filter, pump, pressure control valve, direction control valve, functional control, actuators. And so these are the different components involved in the hydraulic system. And also it has some other components is also there. It should be a cylinder. In that cylinder, piston is there, piston rod is there, and the functional control valve is there. So these are the different components. First we can see the oil reservoir. So what is oil reservoir? To store the fluid. Why it is used the oil reservoir? It is store the fluid. So the reservoir or tank stores the sufficient oil to meet the system's demand. So you can see the basic components of hydraulic system. These are the hydraulic system. So you can see the reservoir, filter, pump, direction control valve, retract and extend, hydraulic cylinder. Okay, so these are the different parts in the hydraulic system. So you can see the diagram of the hydraulic system. You can see the hydraulic system. It is a power supply unit, a hydraulic pump unit, and valve, control valves, and cylinder, reservoir. So, and pressure control valves is also there. So these are the different components involved in the hydraulic system. So you can see the line diagram of the components in the hydraulic system. Okay, so there is a reservoir, pressure regulator, pump, filters, direction control valves, pressure control valves, motors, cylinders, flow control valves. These are the different components involved in the. So you can see about one by one. So the reservoir. So you can see that reservoir, it is mainly used to store the fluid. Okay, it is mainly used to store the fluid. So the reservoir or tank stores the sufficient oil to meet the system's demands. Okay, so manaki enta amount of water anedi requirement undi, nenu enta amount of water anedi store cheskovali, how amount of water and how amount of fluid should be stored in the tank. So that is the usage of reservoir. Okay, so if the reservoir, the flow control is, it should be delivered into 3 times the reservoir. Suppose nu teeskunna pipe outlet pipe anedi daniki 3 times ga flow of control anedi reservoir lo store ayi undalanamata water anedi. Ardhamainda? So it should be, the tank's capacity is usually at least 3 times the pump's maximum delivery rate. So in that delivery rate, it should be 3 times the 3 times maximum capacity on the oil reservoir tank. So that is the usage of reservoir. Okay, so it should be furnished uninterrupted supply of oil to the system and receives the returning oil from the system. Okay, so the uninterrupted oil is entered into the system, it should be returning into the system of the reservoir. So the reservoir is used to mainly to store the fluid from the system. That is the main advantage. So in that reservoir, there is a different components. Pump is there, returning fire filter is there, valves is there, hydraulic cylinder is there, direction. So those are the other components in the reservoir. But mainly, you can see that what is the reservoir and what is the purpose of reservoir? It should be used to store the fluid in the hydraulic system. Okay, so that is the reservoir. So you can see the pressurized reservoir and vented reservoir. There is a two types of reservoir, pressurized reservoir and vented reservoir. So this is the reservoir, and next you can see the hydraulic power unit of reservoir. This is also a one type of reservoir. So the pumping motor is there, pump is there, and the so one pipe is there. It should be pumped into the tank. The pump is used to flow the fluid in one place to the another place. Okay, it is also a one type of reservoir. So the hydraulic tank functions, how it should be function, is the pump. So pump is placed on that reservoir, so it should be pump the water at one place to the fluid at one place to the another place. So it shows of what is a heat generated in the system is given off into the atmosphere. So you can see if the fluid flows in one direction, one place to the another place by using that pump, the heat is generated in the system. Why? Because some temperature is occurred in on that system. And next one, you can see as the hydraulic fluid circulates through lines, and it also it is a recycle, and it comes into the reservoir. It should be reserved and it should be delivered into by using the pump. So it is a recycling procedure of the hydraulic tank functions. So that is the hydraulic tank function. So how reservoir works, it is reservoir working means the one pump is placed on that reservoir. If the pump is used to pumping the fluid from one place to the another place, so you can see to pump means you can see that green arrow mark, that is the pumping. So oil is cooled and air separated out, the time is reached in the inlet option. So that is the usage of pump and how it should be worked on that reservoir. And it can also shows the returning line. So you can see the blue color line, it should be the returning line. The fluid flows into the hydraulic system, it should be converted into a mechanical work, and finally it should be comes into the returning line. It should be flow is directed outward to the tank wall. So that is the returning wall. Okay, so this is the hydraulic tank function, how it should be functioned and how it should be operated, how it should be works. It is the tank function. And filters, so in the hydraulic system, it is also a filter is the one of the main component in the hydraulic system. So the filter here, so it should be, there are basically three types of filters. It is a suction line filters, pressure line filters, and return line filters. So these are the different types of filters. So filter removes or screens the contaminants like dirt, sand, or metallic parts from the oil. So the filter is used to separate the, it should be separate the very high pure oil. Okay, very high amount of pure oil, it should be separated from the dust, rust particles, or sand, or metallic parts from the oil. So oil may be collect the contaminants during its flow through the circuit. So it should be converted into a circuit. So you can see that circuit, there is a functioning of filter. So you can see, so in that reservoir, it should be load and pump and strainer or suction line gauge. So trapped practice, you can see the trapped practice. So it should be used to separate the dust particles from that fluid. Okay, separate the dust particles from that fluid. So finally, we can collect the, finally we can collect the very high pure oil and fluid of the hydraulic system by using the filters. So that is the usage of filters. So in that filter, the most common source of contamination is wear products resulting from actual mechanical wear and metallic corrosion of hydraulic components. So it should be separated from the metallic components and hydraulic corrosion particles and rust particles to the hydraulic system by using the filters. Okay, so if why is filtration necessary? So why it should be filtered in that fluid? Okay, the filters are used to remove the smallest insoluble particles and keep the hydraulic system clean. So it should be clean fluid we are taking in the hydraulic system. Okay, so in that, impurities in the hydraulic system affect the components of the hydraulic system and the shorten their service life. So this is the working of filter, and you can see the purification of oil. So in that oil, in the filtration process, there is a purification occurred. So the number of causes failures in the contamination hydraulic oils and lubricating oils with dirt and water. By separating the dirt and another irregular particles of dust to metallic parts from the fluid, it should be that we are taking the fluid, pure fluid from the hydraulic system. So roughly 80% of hydraulic failures are the result of fluid contamination. So in that fluid, there is a different amounts of dust particles or rust particles are mixed in that fluid. It should be contaminates and it should be failed across the 80% of the hydraulic system. Okay. So then next you can see. So the pump. So these are the total oil contamination, how it should be contaminated oil and how it should be purified from the usage of filters. Okay. So this is the line diagram of filter. So this is the line diagram of hydraulic system, and you can see that pump. So the usage of pump is source of pressure. So it should be draws the oil from the reservoir and delivers it at high pressure to the system. So it should be delivered in one place to the another place of fluid by using the pumps. It should be delivered in the fluid is one place to the another place by using the pressure control valve. In the pressure control valve, the pump is generally driven by an electric motor on an IC engine. By using the engine, so in that pumping machine, we are using the IC engines. So by using that in the electrical IC engine, we can pump the fluid from one place to the another place by using the pump in the hydraulic system. So that is the usage of pump. And next, you can see the pressure control valve. So if the pressure control valve, the fluid is pumped into the one place to the another place, it should be controlled by using the amount of flow rate. It should be controlled amount of flow rate by using the pressure control valve. So in that valves, we can control the flow rate of the pressure control valve. So the pressure control valves protect the system from the accidental overload or the system fault by relieving the excess pressure. So high amount of pressure should be released in that pump. So it should be damaged. A very high amount of load should be acting on that hydraulic system. It should be damaged. So why? Because very high amount of pressure releases, the flow rate is very high. So in that process, it should be, it contaminates different particles and the flow rate is irregular. So in that process, we can control the flow rate of the fluid from using the pressure control valve. Okay, so that is the usage of pressure control valve. And the direction control valve, in the direction control valve, by using the, it should be the fluid flow rate, how it should be delivered and where we to flow the fluid by using the direction control valve to change the direction of fluid. So in the direction control valves provides the means to change the direction of fluid. So for example, one end to the cylinder to the other. So it is also provide a means to shut off the flow completely. So the fluid is passes through one place to the another place. It should be delivered to the pressure control valve. The control of fluid should be changed by using the directional control valve. So the fluid direction should be changed because it should be delivered at straightly. So it is a not working process and it should be damaged. So in the direction control valve, we can flow the fluid control at our required position of the cylinder by using the directional control valve. Okay, so that is the usage of directional control valve and functional control valve. So the functional control valve, after the completion of process in that cylinder, you can see that cylinder and the piston. So the hydraulic energy is converted into the mechanical energy. So the hydraulic fluid is converted into the mechanical energy of that fluid. So in that process, the cylinder is takes place and piston is take place and piston rod is take place. It should be converted into the hydraulic system into the mechanical system. So you can see the functional control valve. After that completion of conversion of mechanical fluid, so the functional control valve, it should be control the speed of actuator by regulating the quantity of fluid throughing it. So the speed of control valve, so the amount of fluid passes through the functional control valve, it should be delivered into one place to the another position of the fluid. It should be control the speed of fluid. So by using the functional control valve, so to decrease the to increase the controlling of fluid from the mechanical fluid. So and the last one is actuators. So in that actuator, it is a device to convert hydraulic energy into a mechanical energy. So this is the main component of the hydraulic system. So the actuator. So the actuator is the mechanical energy is changed into the hydraulic energy. So in that actuators may be linear or rotational in that hydraulic motors. By using the actuators, it should be two different types. There is a linear actuators and a rotational actuators of the mechanical system. So these are the different basic components in the hydraulic system. Okay, in the next class we'll discuss about a new topic. So these are the components of the hydraulic system. Okay.